Welcome to Vocabulary TV. This is our 29th video lesson on roots, prefixes and suffixes in English vocabulary. In this episode, we are going to cover one of the oldest roots, which was used in various Indo-European languages and later on in Latin and Greek languages as well. The words in this video lesson are based on the root nocer, which manifests itself in the following bases: cogn, gno, and con, all of which mean to know or to learn. We can learn several interesting words using this root connection. So let's begin. The very first of these words is notion, derived from notus, which is the past participle of the Latin verb nocere. The word literally means an idea or something that you think you know. In today's English, notion means a conception or belief about something. For instance, everyone has his or her own notions about what an ideal life should be like. In another meaning, the word notion refers to a whimsical idea or an impulse or desire. As an example, consider the following sentence. While at work, she had a sudden notion to ring up her sister and ask her to go shopping. Another word from the word root notus, meaning known, is notorious. And notorious indeed describes someone who is well known, but in a bad sense. A notorious person would be someone like a well-known criminal, as opposed to a well-known actor whom you would rather describe as famous. For example, he is this country's most notorious gangster and a drug trafficker. And to be notorious is to have notoriety, which is a noun meaning the state of being notorious or infamous. An example sentence would be, the GNO episode where some students allegedly shouted anti-India slogans gained much notoriety in the press. And there are other words based on this root, like noble, meaning a well-known and aristocratic person. But let's move on to the word stem gno. If we prefix gno with I and prefix I or in mean not, we get the word ignore, which literally means to not know. And to ignore someone is indeed to pretend like you don't know that person. Like we can see that the guy with headphones is intentionally ignoring or refusing to take notice of the female. The related words are ignorant, which is an adjective used for a person who lacks knowledge or awareness in general, and ignorance, which is a noun. But perhaps one word that you can add to your vocabulary is ignoramus. The word means an ignorant or stupid person. And the best example that comes to my mind is the movie Dumb and Dumber, in which, as the name suggests, two ignoramuses go about doing silly and stupid things, being the living proof of the maxim, ignorance is bliss. The next word is agnostic. Again, the prefix a or an means not. So the word literally means not known. And the only context in which the word is used is when a person believes that nothing is known or can be known about the existence or nature of God. A person who has such beliefs is called agnostic. Now students confuse the words agnostic and atheist all the time. So to highlight the difference, an agnostic is non-committal about the existence of God, but an atheist does not believe in God at all. The word agnostic could also be used in a non-religious context where someone has a doubtful or non-committal attitude about something. For example, until now I have been fairly agnostic about the tax reforms in India. Trying to know a little bit more about the root gno, we have the words diagnosis and prognosis, again a confusing pair, as both words are common in medical terminology. The key to learning them lies in their prefixes. Dia means apart, so diagnosis would literally mean knowing something apart. And diagnosis refers to the identification of the nature of an illness or other problem by examination of the symptoms. Prognosis, on the other hand, literally means to know before and refers to the likely course of a disease or medical condition of how it is going to develop over time. A sentence highlighting this difference would be, After the preliminary tests and analysis of symptoms, the patient was diagnosed with a very rare disease for which it is very difficult to make an accurate prognosis. By extension, we have the word prognosticate, which again means to know something beforehand and so to foretell or predict a future event. For example, she prognosticated that he will soon meet the love of his life. Moving on to the word stem cogn, which again means to know or to learn, we have the very common word recognize, which I hope you would have recognized easily. Breaking the word apart, the prefix re means again. So recognize literally is to know something or someone again. Like we can say that Radha instantly recognized Shyam. Though in a secondary meaning, recognize means to acknowledge the existence, validity or legality of something. For instance, same gender marriages are not recognized by Indian law. Related words are recognition, which is a noun, and recognizable, which is an adjective. Then we have the word incognito, and this word literally means not known and is an entry from Latin to Italian into English. Incognito describes a person or his actions when he keeps his true identity a secret, often by using a different name or disguise. For example, wearing a white mask, he roamed about the city incognito. A related expression is terra incognita, which literally means unknown territory and refers to an unexplored country or field of knowledge. For instance, he thought he knew a great deal about investing in the stock markets, but he had in fact ventured into a terra incognita. Next, we have a very important word, cognition. Simply put, cognition refers to our conscious mental activities involving knowing or learning and even thinking and understanding. For example, theories of human cognition. Anything related to cognition could be described as cognitive. It's an adjective, and an example sentence is, scientists study the cognitive apparatus of human beings to pattern how computers should gather information about the world. We would end this word-based cogn with a very important word that you should be aware of. That word is cognizant, which means having knowledge or awareness. Simply put, being cognizant is being aware. An example would be, as a single parent, he was fully cognizant of his duties towards his adopted child. A related word is cognizance, which is a noun. And at last, we would have a look at the root base, words based on which migrated to English via French. The most popular of such words is connoisseur, which literally means one who has learned or one who knows a great deal about a particular area. The word connoisseur refers to an expert judge in matters of taste, such as a connoisseur of French cuisine or French wine, or even a connoisseur of music or arts. Surprisingly, there is another word which is an exact synonym of connoisseur, and it hails from the same root cogn, but migrated from Italian to English. The word is cognoscente. Ending with E, it's singular, and ending with I, it's plural. Like look at this picture where there are so many people analyzing that painting. They seem to be connoisseurs, or you can use the word cognoscente of art. Then we have the word reconnaissance, and this word is similar to recognize in origin. It refers to the military observation of a region to locate an enemy or ascertain strategic features. For instance, in a typical military maneuver, a few soldiers are first sent on a reconnaissance mission to learn or know about an area before a full-blown attack by the whole army. Next is acquaint, which literally means to come to know. To acquaint is to make someone aware of or familiar with someone or something. For instance, they decided to get acquainted with each other. An acquaintance is a related word that refers to someone you know. And finally, we have the word quaint, which sounds a little different, isn't it? But take my word, it hails from the same root. The meanings change over time and we just need to learn the contemporary one. So the word quaint describes something that is attractively unusual or old-fashioned. Like in this picture, we can see quaint houses in a quaint English village. Now test your understanding of the words learnt in this lesson by filling in the blanks below. It is recommended that you pause the video when the timer starts. And that brings us to the end of this video. Hope you liked it. Subscribe our channel and stay tuned for more such videos. Thank you.